So now that you're familiar with the options in Azure SQL, we thought we'd take a deeper look at the differences between Azure SQL Managed Instance and Azure SQL Database.
Now, when you're going to deploy a managed instance, you're first going to have some choices to make. You can deploy a single instance, which is like a single instance of SQL Server, get these capabilities of your surface area, your virtual networks, all the management capabilities, and then you can deploy databases with that instance. Now, that deployment time, as we're going to talk about more in this series, that actually can take a while a little bit because we're deploying what we call an entire ring for you for your instance. So we have this option now in preview called an instance pool, where you can pre-provision the instance, and then now an instance pool deployment is going to be much, much faster. It's going to be a more cost-efficient migration scenario because, for example, you're going to be able to host smaller numbers of cores in these instance pool situations. Currently in public preview, so you start with an instance, you pick an instance pool, and then what you're going to do is you're going to dive into what you call service tier choices for deploying a managed instance.
And when we look at the service tiers for managed instance, it's a pretty easy decision. There are two options available, general purpose and business critical. Now, most of our customers are running on general purpose, but some of our customers have really extreme requirements that they need around recovery or latency, and they want to take advantage of a readable secondary, which we'll talk about. So those are kind of the main decision points between general purpose and business critical. Now, when it comes to purchasing options, there's only one model, the vCore model. So you don't have to make a choice there. And this is going to let you scale independently your compute from your storage. Now, when we talk about general purpose, you'll hear me talk about remote storage. And what I'm saying here is that your data and log files are going to be stored in remote storage where your TempDB is going to be running on local SSD. To compare that with business critical, everything is going to be running on local SSD. And when we talk about IOPS, and this might be a new term to you, this is IO per second, you're going to get better IOPS from business critical. Additionally, in-memory OLTP is only available in the business critical tier. So if that's something your application or workload requires, you're definitely going to want to consider the business critical tier. And finally, what happens in the back end is we basically deploy an availability group for you. We'll talk more about the details later, but basically we have four replicas for you. And one of those we actually allow you to leverage as a readable secondary. So if you want to separate your read and write workloads, this can be an interesting space with business critical. So for Azure SQL Managed Instance, you really have two options: general purpose, which is going to be best for most of our customers, and business critical for if you need low latency, the readable secondary, or a really fast recovery. Stay tuned for the next video.